Today we are going to make this into this.
Common sense made simple.
So here we are in a Stable Diffusion notebook by the forum. I've made some minor modifications just to simplify it for using video input. But overall, for my members, you can have access to this modified notebook. Otherwise, I'll post a link in the description for the default forum notebook. And first off, if you don't even know what a notebook is, I'll also post a link in the description showing you the absolute basics video, you know, so you can continue on from here. But first off, you need to get the CKPT file, and it's a couple gigabytes.
What?
Download it here, and I'll also post a link in the description for a direct download. But you need to download this and put it in the appropriate place, which is My Drive AI Models. Let's get started. So first things first, I like to tick on this little hamburger table of contents so you can just jump around. It gives you a little more space here. But I've gone through this already. What you would be doing is clicking on this just to save time. I've already done it. I have a V100. I have a Pro Plus account, but this can all be done with the free account or a Pro account. Tick on this, would load this. You would tick on this, this, and this. And it'll take a few minutes. It'll load all this stuff up. Once that's done, now you're gonna go into the settings. So first off, you want it to be on video input. Frames, you just want to make sure you have enough frames as long as your video. You know, if you put, say, your video's 3,000 frames, then you want this to be at least 3,000. But if as long as it's over your frame amount, you'll be fine. As for border, I like to use replicate. I feel with wrap sometimes if it moves too quickly, it might get cut off here and there. But also with replicate, if you're doing a lot of side to side or up and down movements, you might get a mirror effect. For motion parameters, I mean, in this case, you really don't need it. I'm just gonna put the zoom to 1 for my sanity, no movement. And noise schedule, you don't have to worry about that. I discussed that in my all settings tutorial. If you're more curious about independently any of these settings, there'll also be a link for that in the description. Strength schedule is what confuses a lot of people when using video input, because in animation, this is very important. But in video input, this means nothing. So you can totally ignore it. We'll get down to the strength in further down the list that actually controls that, the calculations and the formulas. Color, you know, I wrote here, this is the best, last of best. So you don't need to worry about that. Now this is the important part here. So this is where you're gonna put your video. So I'm gonna set my folders here. We're gonna jump out of full screen. And as you can see, I have my footage here. I'm gonna take it and just drag it in there. It's gonna say reminder, and we'll get deleted when you're done. Okay. Go back to full screen. Now we have this here. You're gonna tick on this, copy the path in here, and paste it, which would be Command or Control V. Now it'll be linked to this video, and you'll notice the size I used, which we'll explain later. Now extracting the frame, this would be, for example, say this video, I think it's 150 frames or something like that. So if I did one, it means it's gonna take every single frame and use it as an initial image. I personally don't like that look. It kind of gets blobby and chaotic. I always go at least 2, so then it would cut it in half and render out every other frame. For this instance, I'm even gonna go 3, which is my favorite because it gives it more of a traditional animation style look. Just remember, when you're cutting out frames though, it's also gonna shorten the length of your video. Now the interpolation, you really don't need to worry about this for this instance. Resume run, unless it crashes, you can skip this section too. So let's get to the fun stuff, which is the prompts.
Fun.
So as you can see, I have this prompt. It's somewhat long. I mean, normally I don't use long-winded prompts, but this is about the maximum length I do. But pretty much a detailed portrait painting of Lane from Serial Experiments. It's an anime show. Check it out, you know. Wearing a bear onesie, character design by Archer, who's a digital artist, and Makoto Shinkai, which is an Japanese animator. Now you notice I put exclamation marks here, so this is a little trick too when you're doing prompts. If you add exclamation marks to something, it's adding weight to it. It's making it stronger. So now it's going to focus. I mean, you can go type a ton of them if you want, you know, or just one. I mean, it all depends what you want, but now it's going to look extra hard at wearing a bare onesie and putting it into the prompt. So what I pretty much just did this to get like an anime style look. You can change around the characters, you can change the artists, you can, I mean, that's what makes this so fun.
So, so much fun.
We'll tick all our settings. Now we have our prompt that we like, so we'll tick that. Now here's the final setting. So for this, you have to make the width and the height the same as your video, or else it's gonna start stretching and getting wonked out.
You know what I mean?
So for my instance, I made my video 7:4 by 5:12. So I adjusted that. Now the seed, since I'm gonna be making this live with you right now, we're gonna get Grace and leave it at -1, which is random. Sampler, you don't need to worry about. Steps, now this is where it maxes out at 250, and I'm gonna do it to the max and I'll explain why in a second. For scale, this controls how much it's gonna look at your prompt. I'm gonna go to 15, which is higher than what I normally do. I usually stay between 10 and 13, but when I have longer prompts, I feel 15 helps a little bit more, but I would never go over 15. Now this you don't need to worry about. That's for batch. I mean, you only want one. You only really use more than one batch when you're working with still images, animation, video input. You never go over one. Batch name, I just typed in my website.
You have to advertise.
Video input to anime, because that's what we're, I'm explaining here. That's what it will save in your Google Drive. Seed behavior, iter, fixed, or random. I'll show you little examples right now of the difference, but for this instance, we're gonna go random because I'm feeling crazy. But even iter, how it counts your seed one by one by one. For example, seed 2 and 3 are still completely different seeds, the same way 6 and 6,000 are still two different seeds in the same set. Random and iter are always kind of similar in a sense. But iter will give you more control later when you're looking at your PNG sequence and you can calculate your seeds if you like, say, a particular frame in your animation, you want to use that again. So a lot of times I'll just keep it to iteration or iter. Grid we don't need. Now this here, strength is important. This would be the same with video input. This would be similar to strength scale above, where it's that. So if you're used to animating, whatever you would use in animation, you would put into here. And for me personally, I'm going 0.48. And originally I was using a simple division formula to explain how 48 will cut into my steps and turn it into 130, which 130 steps for me is ideal, usually. And Joseph Russell actually corrected me and gave me the exact formula, which I'm posting right now. If you really want to get into the math of it, thank you, Joseph, for that information. And so that's pretty much it. For the most part, the masks and all that, we're not going to get into that. I'm going to do a tutorial completely on masks at some point. So we have our prompt, we have this, and we're going to tick on this. And like I said, I'm watching this the same time you're watching this, so this is totally random for me. That's what makes this so exciting, is the whole slot machine
gambling
effect of this. So it's, let's see what happens. I'll speed this up, so we're going to get kind of like a
cool
time lapse effect, and when I come back, we'll have some sort of video input animation, anime cool thing, you know. So look at that already. The first frame was pretty amazing. So I'll see you in when this is done. And also, if you're familiar with using initial images, the strength scale would have the same concept in video as it would in that, with different strengths. I always try to keep it between 0.48 or 0.6. Zoned out for a second there. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
All right. So yeah, you see we got all our frames here and everything. So either you can take your PNG sequence from your Google Drive and, you know, bring it into third-party software, After Effects, Blender, DaVinci, Premiere Pro, you know, all that stuff, whatever people use. And
a lot of people
do it like that with the PNG sequence, or you can go right to here, turn this off, and then I'm gonna leave it at standard 12 frames per second, and you'll see it'll take your PNG sequence and turn it into a little video, which will save in the same place as your drive. And I mean, this is just a quick raw look of what we just created. So that's pretty much it. You know, if you think I missed anything setting wise or, you know, anything, I have a full tutorial on each setting with chapters, so you can go through and use it as a reference if you like. As for the final outcome, obviously, depending on your video, the results may vary. And, you know, any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments. I try to answer as quickly as possible. Tag me. I'd love to see what you're doing with all this stuff. And if you're a member now, I appreciate it. Thank you. If you're not a member, please join. You'll get access to Colab Notebooks and exclusive content and just support the channel. You know, it'd be great. I really appreciate everything you guys are doing, and I hope this really helped you out. And have a great day.
iamYork.com.